Namaste. Right now I'm here in Nepal. I'm in the city Nagarkot, which is very close to Kathmandu. And I must say, Nepal is totally not what I expected. When I thought of Nepal before I came here, I thought of wonderful, beautiful mountain regions, very similar to Austria or Switzerland. But what I got is very much like India. Actually, it is even worse than India. Unfortunately, Nepal is very polluted. Kathmandu is one of the dirtiest cities I have seen in a long time. I think one of the most polluted cities in the world. But who would thought like this of Nepal? Yeah, everybody thinks like Nepal is super clean, nature. Well, you can see here, it's not that bad. Actually, I like it. But the pollution, it's actually very bad. You can't even see the mountains here because of the pollution. So Kathmandu, it's really bad, but there are also other cities around which are actually better. For example, Pokhara. Pokhara is the second largest city in Nepal and it's quite clean. It's not super clean, you still have some pollution, but it's relatively clean. So you can see the mountains in the morning, for example, and the air is quite okay. It's not that bad. And I really like Pokhara. It has a certain vibe, kind of a hippie vibe. Everybody's very relaxed. A lot of hemp stores and chill places, meditation, yoga. I must say I really love Pokhara, but I hate Kathmandu. Not just because of the pollution, also because there are no taxi apps. You don't have Uber, you don't have Grab, and all the taxi drivers try to cheat you. So you're gonna pay a lot of money for a taxi, about $1 per kilometer, which is very, very high compared to the local prices. Locals only pay about 40 cents, but foreigners gotta pay a dollar, and if it's late, they will even try to charge you more. So you have to negotiate that you just get the dollar. So, and that's what I don't like. But generally, the attitude of the people is really, really nice. People are super friendly, and yeah, everybody's kind, especially in Pokhara, also in Kathmandu. Of course, they wanna make money, it's normal. But it's not as bad as in India. So I would say people are friendlier than in India, although in India are also many friendly people. And India is a big country, yeah? So every region have different people. So you can't just generalize India in one place. Yeah? It's very, very different. South India, North India, people change like the food. But still, not too much. Yeah? The same like here, Nepal is very much like India, I would say. I still like the country, but it's totally not what I expected. Yeah, I've been to Pokhara, Kathmandu and Nagarkot, so this is my opinion. Also in Pokhara there was like a little mountain nearby, I think it's Sagarkot, or the names, I'm really bad with names. But this was really nice, it was just too cold, yeah, because now it's the middle of March, and here the temperature is very, very comfortable. You see, I'm sitting here in a t-shirt. It's 4 p.m. It's not too bad, but if you go very high in the mountains, it's really cold. Also, another thing which I noticed here is that the temperatures are fluctuating extremely. So, that you can have at least 10 degrees difference between the highest temperature of the day and the lowest temperature. In countries like Thailand, you will have temperature fluctuations of 3-4 degrees maybe, but here you have 10, 12, maybe 15 even. That is really one of the highest I've ever experienced in the world. As well, it's the only country where you have a time zone difference of only 15 minutes. This is very unique and also very confusing when you talk to other people in other countries and you have to calculate the time. 15 minutes, what exactly is it? 45 minutes? Whatever, it's very interesting. That really makes the country unique. Also, generally, it's quite cheap. It's about the same price of India. Some things are more expensive, like taxis, accommodation and food. It's about the same. Yeah? Could be a little bit more expensive. What I've noticed is that tourist activities, so everything related to tourism, is quite expensive. Well, hotels not, but activities like paragliding, you pay $60, bungee jumping, $100. It's more than Thailand. Yeah? Although general prices are quite low, tourist activities are super expensive. Renting a motorbike, it's like $8, it's not that cheap. Petrol is expensive, more than a dollar. Yeah, so this is what I experienced. But it's all in all, it's not that bad. But I really hope the worst thing is the pollution and transportation. Oh yeah, transportation. The roads here. The roads are the worst in the world. I've never experienced so horrible roads. It's so bumpy. You know when you're in an amusement park like Disneyland, you go to this theater where the chairs are shaking, you see like Star Wars or Star Trek or some science fiction movie and the chair is kind of like super shaky. It's like here when you ride a bus, yeah, but you don't have a movie, you're just on the road, because these are the bumpiest roads in the world, I would say. It's kind of like Africa, but the main roads in Africa are better than the main roads here, you know? So it's really annoying. And the first night when I came from the border of India to Kathmandu, I took the night bus, and it was, you can't sleep, it's horrible, you know, when the bus is going fast and go through a hole, you kind of fly out of your seat, yeah, and who can sleep like this when you fly? It's impossible. Even the locals couldn't sleep. There's no way you can get used to it. So because I was so tired, sometimes I fell asleep for 2-3 minutes, but I always had to wake up. And this was the, honestly, I've took many bus rides, and this was the worst bus rides of my life. I couldn't sleep at all, and I usually easily sleep anywhere, but this was so bumpy. My Fitbit, which counts steps, they counted me 30,000 steps, really. So I just say I burned 5,000 calories, even though I was sitting. This is so wrong, you know, but that's how bumpy the roads are. Even North Korea have better roads than Nepal. So this is one thing, the pollution and roads quality, it's really bad, but people are quite friendly, relatively honest, and the food is, for me, quite delicious, quite spicy, but it's not too bad. It's very much like India, so it's not too different. Yeah, unfortunately, I probably will never see the Mount Everest because of the pollution. It's very, very sad, but hopefully from Tibet, I might have the chance to see it. Anyway, I enjoyed my time here, and I still have a few days left. So I'm going to Kathmandu, enjoy the pollution, and enjoy the food especially, which is the best around here. Try to learn a little bit more about the culture. I actually also did a farm stay in Pokhara, which was very interesting. Living on a local farm, getting the vegetables, seeing the buffaloes. Unfortunately, you can't milk the buffaloes because they're super shy. So only locals can milk them. They take about 2 weeks to get used to new people. Yeah? So I couldn't milk the buffalo. Also, this was super expensive, this farm stay. It's like $40. $40 for what? Yeah, for helping the vegetables and yeah, getting some food, but like really, really low quality food. It wasn't that good, but it was still a nice experience, but maybe not worth the money. Anyway, you can have a glimpse of the local life, how hard it is for the local people, how they make organic food and stuff like this. Yeah, anyway, I love the country. It's still nice, even though there's some downsides. I really recommend Pokhara as my favorite place, with the Fewa Lake and the mountain view. But I haven't been trekking because I'm afraid to not have internet connection. I need internet connection for many reasons, for work and stuff, because I travel and walk all the time. So anyway, Nepal, highly recommended, but only at certain times and certain places. And yeah, let me know what you think about Nepal. And if you're a local, thank you for your hospitality. You're one of the most friendly people, one of the friendliest people in the world. Yeah, thanks. Cheers.